Welcome to QGIS 101. My name is Andreas de Jong, and in this video I'm going to show you how to make contour lines. I hope you enjoy it.
I'd like to dedicate this video to Abu Asal, who sadly passed away last week in Amman, Jordan. Abu Asal was our IT expert on the water project in Afghanistan, and we're all going to miss him. Welcome to Kabul in Afghanistan. We have an ongoing project in the Bagrami industrial area, so I thought what we do today is to try to make a contour map of this area. The first thing we're going to do is download the digital elevation model, which has a resolution of 30 meters, that's the SRTM model, and then we're going to smooth it a little bit using a Gaussian filter, and finally I'll show you how to make contour lines of the area, so that we can use that as a nice background map to our ongoing field investigation data. Okay, the first thing we need to do is to download our digital elevation model. And there is quite a fast way. We just go to Plugins, Manage and Install Plugins, and all you do is you type in SRTM, and you'll get the SRTM downloader. So you install it, and then you'll see here an icon. That's what it looks like. Click on it, and we need to set the extent of the area of interest. So let's set it to the canvas and just press download. Now there's only one tile that's relevant to this area, and it is north 34 east 69. What you need, of course, is a Earth data login. So you just go to nasa.gov and Earth data and get yourself a username and a password if you don't have one already. Now there is another way, and that is that we make sure we are in WGS 84 geographic, EPSG of 4326, and then we just have a look at our coordinates. In this case it's 69.22 34.51. We go to our rasters, SRTM 30, and we're looking for 34 69, so north 34 east 69, which is this one. We grab a file and we pop it onto our map, and everything should go black, and it doesn't, maybe because it's already in the wrong folder. Here we go. Okay, if we zoom out a bit, we can see that our area is covered by this digital elevation model, and the bottom left-hand corner has coordinates of 69 degrees east, 34 degrees north. It looks a bit boring, so what we're going to do is change the symbology. Just double-click on the data layer and go to symbology, and we're going to change it to a single-band pseudo-color, and also let's change the color ramp. We can say apply just to see what it looks like, but we'd like to change this color ramp, so I'm going to click on it and say create new color ramp, select catalog CPT city, say okay, because that has a vast amount of different ramps, and then we're going to use topography, and my favorite one is this one, the Wiki Schwarzwald. Press OK and apply. There aren't many divisions here, so it's in continuous mode. Let's press classify, and from the 5 we should have about 100 now. If we say apply again, there's going to be a big improvement. I'll just close this for a second and zoom in to our project area, which is here. Okay, and let's switch it back on. Okay, we've got a lot of different divisions, but as you can see, everything here is completely green. So we're going to have to change the minimum and maximum meters so that we have a bit more of these colors here. Now, I've done this before, so I know what it should be, 1790 as a minimum. And as a maximum, we're going to use 1880. So you just get this by trial and error. But as I said, I did this before, and this is what I've chosen to show the colors of this area. So you can see there's a kind of a ridge here and also slightly higher land down here in the south. If you look at this digital elevation model, you can see that there's quite a bit of noise in there, okay? It looks a bit patchy. So if we were to make a contour line of this, it would not be very smooth. Now, we could contour it and then smooth the contours later, but that requires a lot of computing power every time we open up the map. So my advice to you is to smooth the digital elevation model first before you contour it. So we go to Processing Toolbox and just type in Gauss. And this is the one we want, the Gaussian filter from SAGA. Just double click it and it has chosen the correct layer. We put in a standard deviation of 10, a search mode of circle, and just leave the rest as it is. It's going to make a temporary file. Just press run and see what happens. It might take a few moments. Okay. All right, so we have our layer here. It's called result, and it's completely gray. But not to worry, what we do is we go to our previous layer and we go styles, copy style, go to our result, right click, styles, paste style. What we can do now is have a quick look at our result compared to our previous digital elevation model, and you can see that it has taken out all the noise quite nicely, but still preserved the main topographical features. So this little ridges here, for example, haven't been wiped out. So what we're going to do now is to contour this data. And the way we do that, we just go to Rasters, Extraction, Contour. It has taken the correct input layer. And here we get to choose the interval between the contour lines, and I would like to have a 5 meter interval. And just leave everything else as it is and press run. Now, this takes a bit of time, so now's a good time to go and have yourself a cup of tea or a cup of coffee, or maybe do some other work. We can just press close, and our blue bar down here means that it's working. And just have to be a bit patient while it's calculating in the background. Okay, the contouring has finished, and we have a new layer called output, which are the contour lines. Now, despite the Gaussian smoothing, there are a few bits and pieces left over which are not so nice. There's like a little piece here and there, and maybe here, which we're going to remove now. Just double click on the layer and go to Symbology and Line, Simple Line. And here we're going to use the Geometry Generator. In the geometry type, we need to use line string, multi-line string. And you'll see here, there's a bit of code that's going to control which lines are going to be shown. And what we're going to do is use an if statement. So if, open brackets, the dollar length is greater than 500 meters, then show the geometry. If not, don't show the geometry. Close brackets. And press apply. You'll notice that the little ones that were here have disappeared. So I'll just close this for a second. Yeah, it has cleaned up the smaller pieces. Basically, every contour line that's less than 500 meters long has been removed from the display. Now, at the top of the mountains, it means maybe there's a couple of them missing here, but at least we don't have too many which are like littering the map with little pieces. The next thing which we're going to do is change the color of the line. It's in black, but let's choose a kind of a brown color, maybe something like this, and press OK. Apply. The contour lines are looking nice, but what I'd like to do now is to highlight every contour line that can be divided by 50 meters. So let's say 100, 150, 200, and so on. The way we do that is we go to here, the width option, and click on here, edit to open the expression string builder. Now here we will say if the elevation divided by 50 equals 0, then make the line width 0.5. If LF divided by 10 equals 0, then make the line width 0.2, and for all the others just make it 0.1. Check down here that we don't have any errors. Press OK and apply. You'll see what's happened now is that every 50th contour line is a bit wider, and then every 10 meters also it's a little bit thicker, and the ones in between are the thinnest ones. The next thing we need to do is create some labels. So we'll say single labels, and for the labels we want the elevation. What I'd like to do is only label every 10 meters, so not all of the contour lines. Again, we'll click on the expression dialog and we'll say if the elevation divided by 10 equals 0, then elevation concatenate with space meters, else put nothing. And you'll see down here that it has not produced any errors. Just press OK and apply. The other thing we would like to do is change the text size, make it a little bit smaller. Let's say 8. And also I'd like it to have the same color as the contour lines. So just click down here, recent colors, press on the brown one, press apply. You'll see that it's a little bit difficult to read some of these because there's lines behind them. So we'll click on the background and say draw background, press apply. The next thing is we're gonna work a bit on the placement. I'd like them all to be written on the line, not above the line. And I'd also like them to be curved. Let's have a look at it. And if we look at our contour lines, you see there's not so many. So let's repeat them every 500 pixels and see what that looks like. So there's a couple more labels now on our contour lines. Okay, let's just check what it looks like. So I'm quite happy with this final product. What we need to do now is to save it, because this of course is only a temporary file, and you can see that because it's in temp. And what it means is if I close down QGIS, we're gonna lose all our work. So what we're gonna do is export save features as, and I don't want to use an S3 shapefile, we're going to use the GeoPackage QGIS data GeoPackage, and I'm going to stick it in Kabul, press save, and the layer name is going to be So there's an existing file. I'm going to overwrite it. But as you can see, it has lost all the formatting. No problem. What we do is we're going to go to our output layer, go to styles, copy styles, all style categories, and just paste the styles into our new layer. And when we switch it on, it has all the new styles. Okay. Now, every time I open this file, I would like to have the correct style. So the way we do that is we go into properties and Symbology and down here style, and we say save as default in the data source. Okay. That means if I load this again in future, it will have all the styles as shown here. Another thing we can do is we can export the style as a QGIS layer style file, and I always have it in maps, QML, and it's called contours SRTM 30 10 meters. Press save. Yes. So I've just loaded a new set of contour lines. And if I want to format them, all I need to do is go to Properties, Symbology, Style, and say Load Style, and look for the QML file, which is hiding in Maps 3QML. Say Open, Load Style, Apply, OK. Wasn't that easy? That means that I can use this formatting for any contour lines of Afghanistan very quickly and without any problems at all. And if I want to change some of the parameters, it's quite easy. I just double click on here and say look at the symbology, click on the geometry generator, maybe change that to, I don't know, let's say 300 meters, say apply, okay, and maybe I'll have a few more contour lines popping up here and there. So I hope you found that useful and interesting and informative, and see you in the next video.